Yeah, they're still scared of us, Johnny, about these horses in Texas. They're still scared of us.
Well, every time that moon is bright, it makes me, my blood wants to get some horses somewhere.
We went to a ranch northwest of Lubbock. Historic ranch. Big one. They took us out till we drove up, and everybody was looking around. I saw everything. It was nice, a lake, pond, except I asked my buddy. I said, hey, what did they do with the horses? Somebody else over there said, they knew you were coming. They hit them. We're still known for stealing horses. We have a tree over here. Was it you? Yes, we have a tree that we're going to go to the committee in Texas or wherever it takes. He's got a tree very similar to, I think, what you're describing. I was there, too. And we'll talk to you about that tree. Okay. I got a white car sitting over there, and it's full of things that I'll give you. It's full. I went back there. I said, good gosh, what is this? All these bones you see, Mr. Laurie, my trunk is half full of these bones. I said, what is this? My granddaughter said, Grandpa, I'm taking those for our dog. My dog lacks bones. I don't know how I'm going to get them out of there, but I wouldn't have room for everything. We can't take all them bones. I don't know how long supper's coming along. This gentleman sitting right here is a good friend of Mr. Laurie's. Come up. You were here last year. Next is the lady sitting right over here in front of me.
Well, my name is Mark Reynolds, my wife Brenda, and we are good friends with the Lowry's. He and I were professional colleagues. We're both retired dentists now, and after being retired dentists, I grew up in the cattle business, but had not been in the cattle business, and Dr. Lowry did it. So anyway, I started hanging out with him out here on the ranch and stuff, and through our friendship, and then his son, where's Landon? I don't know where Landon is, but anyway, I'm kind of right between them age-wise. We've been friends for a long, long time, and I said in professional colleagues, but anyway, I've had the opportunity to come out on the ranch here for now for quite a bit for the last 7 or 8, 10 years, I never did ever take it for granted, because you could just tell there was something about this place that was special. I could see it in the family, the Lowry family, what they felt about it. And that was more than reinforced the last couple of years, because I have not had the opportunity to meet with Judge Crum and the Parkers. And after being here and seeing what it means to them, now I sure know why it's special. And I feel very privileged, because while y'all get to come once every year or two, I can come out here anytime I want to because of my friendship with the Lowry's. And I want y'all to know I don't take that for granted now. It's very, very special. I've got chill bumps on my arms right now saying that to you guys. So anyway, I appreciate the opportunity to meet all the people that are here, the respect that everybody shows towards each other. It's just a wonderful, wonderful event, experience. And when I try to tell people about it that I see, you can't put it into words, or at least I'm not capable of putting it into words, but I sure do appreciate the opportunity and to see all you folks.
Thank you. Thank you. Landon Laurie, I did recognize you. This is Dr. Laurie's son. He works out of Dallas, Fort Worth.
Dallas, yes, sir.
I think he's a banker. Are you?
Most of the time.
He won't loan me any money, though.
Okay, come up. We got 8 minutes till we eat, and we're going to break. And when we come back, this young lady right here.
Well, I really appreciate getting to
enjoy this. The first time that I was involved was what, probably 23 or 4 years ago. Pretty close. So yeah, it really is a great place out here. Just all the history that goes through and getting to learn just what we've learned in there a little bit ago, getting to meet all the people has been fascinating for 2.5 decades for me. So glad that y'all are all here. This is a really neat deal. We got good weather. I mean, it could have been 120 degrees out here. or 12 or both. Not at the same time. But anyway, I really, really do appreciate the opportunity to meet the people, to learn about both the culture, in historical culture, the culture today, and the different personalities that go along with that. So thank y'all. I'm glad you come up. I hope you all enjoy yourselves. And thanks for coming.
Give a hit. We have 5 minutes, so you're going to let me come up.
Good job. Sure. Maybe if I got something for you. This is going to be extremely off the cuff because I had no idea it was coming. But thank y'all so much for having me here, especially, I don't know if I see Judge Crum anywhere around. But he has been extremely helpful to me in both just like getting me out here, introducing me to all y'all, and also just like writing a really incredible book. So I'm very grateful to him for everything. Most of my sort of encounter with Cynthia Ann Parker has been through books, and so it's really amazing to be here on the land where it actually happened and to talk to people. I feel like perhaps like 60% of my life these days is just like explaining to everyone that I'm writing a master's thesis about Cynthia Ann Parker and then having to explain who that is. So just being in a space where everybody's on the same page has been a huge blessing. And today was just a really special day, and it was lovely to be able to take part and hear some Comanche culture and to hear the Comanche language spoken in traditional spaces is a huge privilege and a huge honor. And I'm just grateful that y'all were able to share that with us. I wrote a really sad poem today on our medicine walk. If y'all would like to hear it, I can pull it out. So I probably should have clarified, but I am a poet in residence at the University of Texas at Austin. And for the past 18 months, I've been working on a book that started out being about Cynthia Ann Parker, and then it became about so much more. And I've kind of been training myself to be a historian as that process goes along, that I just became very interested in her story, but also the stories of women that were involved in her story, where there'll be a footnote of just like something that bad that happened to a woman, and wanting to know more about their lives and kind of get an understanding of the two cultures as they would have existed in the 19th century. And I originally, when I started working on this project, was very much just looking through the history books, looking through archival documents, doing all those things, and then over time it's become a lot more immediate and emotional, and today being able to see people who are descended and who have real ties to this story has been really special. So this morning on our medicine walk, when I got to see the river for the first time, I had a really emotional experience and I wrote a poem, and I'll read it for y'all now. I don't have a title for it yet. What will we tell our children? That there was singing in the time of wolves? That when the river ran with blood, the sun still rose each morning against a sky pink as a thing just born. I came and I washed myself in that river. In its motion, I heard the voices of the dead. They said, be easy and remember. What will I tell my children? I will tell them, carry with you a soldier's heart and a poet's knives. So I don't know how that poem's gonna end yet, but I wrote it this morning. But I just appreciate y'all so much, and I know this is extremely off the cuff, had nothing planned, but it's just been really meaningful to me to be out here, and I would love to talk to anybody who wants to chat a little bit more about what I've been working on and just how y'all relate to this story as well. So thank y'all so much for having me. I've had a blast.
Thank you.
I didn't know you were writing something on Cynthia Ann, but I know both of you ladies will do good, and we'll help you all we can. Johnny Pauley is probably, in my mind, I admire him the most as a respected leader in our tribe. And I tell you what, I don't brag with too many people. He's the best. If you need Lucia, in fact, she has said several times, go to Johnny's page for Comanche. So whatever he does working on, he's trying very hard. And I hope that, Johnny, encourage you to keep it up. You're on the right track. Keep working with my grandsons. If you can make them behave, listen more, I appreciate that. We're ready to eat. And if, Johnny, can you give us a prayer for the food?
Pray. I was just wanting to say that on Facebook, it's Comanche Word of the Day, and I put up some videos, and then my computer got hacked, so all my photos were gone, so I had to reload a whole bunch of photos, and I'm still working on trying to get back to making videos of words, and everybody wants me to start phrase of the day or sentence of the day now, so I'll be working on that as soon as I get some photos, more photos. I'm not so tired. Tu mek nama abgad nami tui tua ik ta takapa nami sutai naru Jesus. Ora menanikui.
Amen. All right, folks. I think you can light up. I like your short prayer. I can understand most of it. I understand most of it. He says some good things. Light up.